While officiating at the International Ombuds Day, which is marked on the second Thursday of October, to check on the quality of service delivery, the Prime Minister Robin Nabanja expressed concerns over increased cases of absenteeism of civil servants. Nabanja wondered why absenteeism remains high even among the scientists who have just received hefty salary increments.
Among the public servants, many health workers, when we were in these barazas, and teachers, we were told that continue to be absent from duty. This is happening even after a government has enhanced the salaries of scientists. Is there value for money? And remember, other civil servants are in line for enhancement. Does it mean that when you enhance salaries of servants, does it increase or does it add any value to the services they give us?
At the event organized by the Inspectorate of Government in Kampala, Nabanja took a swipe at agricultural extension workers over underperformance. She noted that most of these don't want to leave offices to visit farms, but rather spend most of their time in bars. She also condemned corruption cases in the parish development model where parish chiefs ask for kickbacks from beneficiaries. She proposes amendment of the law to provide for rewarding whistleblowers who save public funds from being swindled.
The agriculture extension workers, they spend most of their time in offices, in bars, in trading centers, playing pool. And this came out from the people. That's why I want to agree with the IGG that the barazas had worked. Because during those big meetings, some of you have seen this, people were able to tell us, no, those people are always here with us in bars. They don't come to tell us what to do. And the president said, these people have got very good information that can transform our agriculture sector.
Ombudsman is the third cardinal role of the IGG after fighting corruption and monitoring the leadership code of conduct. This role gives the IGG the mandate to check on government service delivery in the interest of the citizens. The International Ombuds Day was organized under a theme of raising citizen awareness of ombuds' role for better services.
This dialogue, working to raise awareness to the entire population of Uganda, to demand as a right that if you're holding a public office, you must serve with diligence or get out of that office. This is what we want to promote throughout the country. So I'm telling Ugandans out there, if you are going to the Ministry of Lands to get your land title, and they say come today, come tomorrow, it is not ready, and you find a court on the chair today, and tomorrow there's a court, there is no officer. And when you find the officer, he's reading his newspaper, he's talking and laughing on the phone, he's on the playing computer games, and then he tells you, come tomorrow, I am busy.
The Inspector General of Government, Betty Kamya, reminded civil servants that rendering service to Ugandans is not a favor, but a constitutional obligation, and asked the public to report to the IGG whenever they don't get adequate services from government facilities.
To promote a total mindset change where the public officials themselves must acknowledge that they are paid salaries by the taxpayer and therefore they must serve diligently. And when they don't, the people should know that they have somewhere to report.
Anne Muhaire, the deputy IGG in charge of ombudsman function, condemned infights among employees in public service, saying their actions are frustrating service delivery.
Insist that there is a very serious problem that must be addressed. Public officers are at war. There is a silent war within institutions. ED, deputy ED, you know, and you know when it gets to the technical people, then there is no work, there is no service delivery. This must be addressed. For a long time, it has been ignored. Government maybe looks on while it happens, but it must be addressed.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.